Hey everyone! Gather around for a fresh update from the world of royal family drama. Today, we're diving into a bit of a mystery that's got everyone talking. Picture this, a key player in the Sausage Squad, a group fiercely loyal to Meghan Markle, has suddenly vanished from the scene. That's right, the account known as Pagan Felony, with a whopping 30,000 followers, is nowhere to be found. You can imagine how this has sent ripples through the squad, leaving many wondering what happened. Was it financial woes that led to this disappearance? That's one theory floating around. In the midst of this, Princess Pinocchio on X is stirring the pot with some juicy gossip. She's hinting that another big name in the squad is busy erasing audio files, possibly to cover up a connection between the voice of Pagan Trelawney and someone else. And then there's Ian Sexton, who's apparently deleting tweets left and right. It seems like they're a bit late to the damage control party, doesn't it? But let's not forget the bigger picture here. Remember the relentless tabloid attacks on Meghan Markle? The speaker recalls how the Globe went after her in 2023, putting her on the cover as one of Hollywood's 50 biggest liars. Talk about ending the year on a sour note, right? You can almost hear the frustration in the speaker's voice saying, oh my God, I don't know how to talk about this topic anymore. It's like they're at their wits' end with the never-ending drama surrounding Meghan and her supporters. And if we rewind a bit, before Meghan became the center of attention, there was the Prince Andrew scandal. The Speaker's channel, known for its body language analyses, originally tackled this story, notably in Spanish. They called it vanilla stuff, but with a creepy twist involving plushy toys, something that might pique you the interest of Japanese horror fans. So there you have it, just another day in the saga of royal controversies and the dedicated followers trying to navigate through the storm. Stay tuned for more updates as this story unfolds. All right, let's keep the royal tea spilling. Recently, Prince Andrew has been making waves again, and honestly, it's been pretty awkward for the royal family. We're talking about allegations and claims that are still up in the air, unverified and hanging like a dark cloud. The speaker we've been following is all about due process, reminding us that rubbing shoulders with the wrong crowd can bring a whole world of trouble. Now, here's where it gets more tangled. Princess Eugenie, part of the York family and Andrew's daughter, seems a bit out of the loop with the whole scandal. Just as her dad started trending for all the wrong reasons, she decided to post updates for the anti-slavery collective. Not the best timing, right? The backlash was immediate, and Eugenie's response. She just turned off the comments on her post. Our speaker isn't impressed, suggesting that sometimes the smartest move is to lay low, maybe even hunker down at home with your teddy bears. In this storm of controversy, that might have been a wise choice. Meanwhile, the Met Police made a statement about the Epstein court documents, basically saying they're keeping an eye on things and will act if new, relevant info pops up. But here's the kicker. They already did an investigation 2 years ago and Prince Andrew wasn't charged with anything. So what gives? Now here's a twist. Why aren't Harry, Meghan, and their supporters jumping on this to criticize the royal family? Our speaker has a couple of theories. Either Prince Andrew's issues aren't as severe as they seem, or maybe he's got some leverage over Harry and Meghan. Intriguing, right? And to add another layer to this royal puzzle, the Daily Mail recently dropped a video of Prince Andrew at the 2023 Christmas service. We can't hear what he's saying, but his body language and facial expressions are on full display. The speaker reads into these, but we're left to wonder what's really going through Andrew's mind in that moment. Stay with us as we delve deeper into these royal riddles. And now, back to Prince Andrew and his latest public appearance. There he was at the 2023 Christmas service, seemingly loving all the attention. Cameras were flashing, and Andrew? He looked almost amused as if he was saying, "Come on, see it from my side." It's no secret that Prince Andrew isn't exactly camera shy, and this recent sighting just reinforces that. But here's a thought. Should there be some sort of rule about royals, especially Andrew, interacting with the public? Given his history and the potential for, let's say, missteps, maybe some guidelines wouldn't hurt. Switching gears, let's talk about Queen Margaret of Denmark. Big news there. She's stepping down, and her son Frederick is stepping up. Now, the timing is interesting. Just after some, let's call them lively, photos of Frederick in Madrid. Hit the internet, the Queen announces her abdication. Officially, it's for health reasons, maybe linked to her smoking. But our speaker can't help but wonder if there's more to the story. Then there's the buzz about Frederick and Mary of Denmark. People are talking about a chill in the air between them. But at a recent mansion event, their body language was pretty standard royal fare. Think William and Catherine, just doing their royal thing, moving from point A to point B. And with that, we wrap up today's royal roundup. What do you think about all this? Drop your thoughts in the comments, and if you're into these royal dramas, don't forget to share this with your friends. For all the latest updates, hitting that subscribe button is a great idea. Thanks for tuning in, and keep an eye out for more juicy updates coming your way.